Hey guys, Frank here. Just wanted to do a quick video on reskinning cells. So why would anybody in their right mind get cells that they've harvested from laptop batteries and want to reskin them? We're going to cover that right now. So why reskin 18650 cells that we've harvested from laptop batteries or from any other source when we get them, even new ones? One of the main reasons is safety. Safety is really first and foremost why we would do that. A lot of times when we harvest cells, they end up being damaged like these, where the skins are ripped off or just mucky or bad. And so it's a good idea to put a fresh skin on so that you have less chance of actually short-circuiting the cell. So it's good to be able to reskin a cell. Another reason is so that the cells will fit in the cell holders. If you have a cell that you're trying to, you know, mount into these cell holders to make these cell packs, the cell needs to be able to fit, and you don't want it something that's too tight or weird, and if you have to force it in, you could actually cause problems. So it's best to have a good fresh skin so that when you're using those holders, cell holders, you're not going to have items that are damaged or mucky. The other thing that one of the reasons I like to do it is because I spend a lot of time cleaning up these cells, making them the way I like them, and I want them to look good. I just do. And maybe it's an arrogance, pride thing, but I don't know. I want them to look good. So I reskin my cells. One of the reasons is so that they look good, because I like the way the cells look when they're consistent. And I even like to put my logo on them. I put the logo that I've developed for the DIY engineer. I like to put it on my cells. They're mine. I take ownership of them. So that's another good reason in my mind to do that. One other thing, it's just something else to spend money on. It's what we're wanting to do anyways, right? We just go and, yeah, we spend all this time, and, you know, if you're spending $1 a cell or $2 a cell or $5 a cell, I don't know why, because there's good cells out there that you don't have to spend that kind of money. But if you're doing that, you want to take ownership and you want it to look nice, and why not? Let's spend some money on something else. Actually, it's pretty cheap, and I'm going to leave some links below on some different skins that I've seen that I've used myself. There's a lot of them that you can get them in large rolls or you can get them pre-cut. So it's really up to you on how you want to spend your money. And it comes down to really the number of cells that you plan on reskinning. So with that, what I want to do is actually jump in and show you some bad cells, show you some the reskinning process that I use. I've actually ran across some of the skins or some of the cells that Tesla has put out, and they actually leave them the metal looking, and or the whatever it is, aluminum, chrome. They're really sleek, nice looking cells. And so I use a clear sleeve over the top of my label and the cell so that it gives a really nice look. So let's jump over the bench and let's reskin a few, just so you can see my process on reskinning cells. So I just want to give some examples of some cells that are kind of gunky. Here's some Samsung cells that came out of some laptop batteries that they were really gummy. They had all sorts of this glue and gunk on them. They don't come clean. You can't really pick it off. A lot of times you can scrape at it, but I'd be taking forever. And then this is one that's kind of a safety issue because it's exposed. You have the positive end of this cell. The negative goes all the way up the cell. And so having that properly coated is important. The other thing that's important to have is these gaskets, making sure that you have good gaskets on the top. These give a good separation between the positive and the negative right here. And then as you go and you place a skin on, this is a clear one, and here's a red skin. And when you put those on, it covers that end, so you actually have good coverage. All right, so let's see. If I had cells just don't fit when they're properly, when they're gummy. And that's really the point I want to make, is when you have one that's gummy, it doesn't go in. And after you've reskinned them, they fit in really nice. They're just a nice smooth fit, and you want them to be that way. So anyway, so let's move on to actually reskinning a couple of these cells. So I have one here that has already been stripped, and I will show you my labels. These are the labels that I create. They're just regular Avery 15695 labels that I run through a laser printer. And they have my logo, and the other thing I put on here is the cell ID, the milliamp hours, and the make and model if I know it. On some of these cells I do know it, on others I don't. And then all I do is I just find a good clean place to place this. And I'm going to stick this probably, you know, I'm going to strip this because I really don't like having all of the lettering on there. That's what the steel wool's for. If I just take and buff it just a little bit on the negative side down here. Try not to get it up on the end because it, like you saw, it sparks. I can clean that up and give it a nice shiny look. So I know this is time consuming, but it's, to me, it's worth it because I've already spent a lot of time putting these cells together. And then I just try to center it the best I can on my cell so it's nice and clean looking, and then I seal it down to the cell itself. So now that cell actually has a label on it, and then I take and open up a skin and slide the skin over the top so that it is pretty much sealed in there. Now, one of the things that I do is I use, you can't really see it down here, but I have like five washers, little tiny washers that are stacked up, and I just stick the negative end down on it. And that way there I get the same distance on the bottom each time. And then I place my my gasket on top here. And then when I have with my gasket, and then I use, and you can use any number of things. So I have a heat gun that I picked up at Harbor Freight. You can use a lighter, but you'd go through a lot of lighter fluid. I even have a butane torch that I could heat this thing up and really torch this. But I've found that just having my little heat gun works really well. So I'll just heat this up a little bit and shrink it on there. So it just gives me a nice shrink wrap on the top. And I go right down the seams. And then I do the bottom, making sure that I have a good coverage. All right, here you have it. That skin, that cell's been reskinned with my logo and all the demographic information on there, and it fits nicely in the cell holder. And I'll just do a couple more here in time lapse. You can watch me do them, and then just kind of give you an idea of the way I do it. Oopsie, I almost forgot my gasket. I'm gonna make sure I get that on there. All right, I hope that was helpful. You know, really what it comes down to is safety. When you're working with this much energy, you start building out power walls, you know, that run 10, 20, 40, 100 kilowatts. And just having one cell not right, you know, it may not be that dangerous, but overall, it's just a good practice to have. All right, thanks for watching. Hopefully this was helpful. Please subscribe, or at least give me a thumbs up so I know that you've been watching. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. And please be safe as you are working on your electrical projects using 18650 cells or whatever cells you might be using. Till the next video, have a good one.